institution ain't solution for the lives that have been lost. By the time you hear this song, there'll be plenty, plenty gone. Time my sis be under grass while the killers be at home. Now my dealers keep that chrome and my pimp, pimp keep them hoes. I'm gon' keep on pushing this pen, I don't write on no iPhone. Alright, I'm old fashioned, but my style cannot be grown. Timeless plastics on you bastards, Jedi.
Some paths must eventually cross. And as two of the greatest fighters in the UFC kept dominating their opposition, it was inevitable that this moment would come. When the octagon door closes for tonight's super fight, the talk will be over. And the entire sports world will come to a halt. This is no ordinary fight. It's a battle between two champions, willing to put their own divisional crowns on the line to prove themselves worthy to be on top. And when the dust settles, there can only be one winner, a king with two crowns.
Coming up next, how good is this? A matchup for the UFC welterweight division title. All right, so here we go with this epic fight, one of the biggest fights in UFC history, given what is at stake. Here comes the UFC champion trying to add another title in a second division simultaneously. Doesn't happen every day, folks. We could all witness history here tonight.
As he steps towards his cage, he understands this is one of the biggest moments in his life, the biggest moment in his career. He is looking to take this title, and he believes his time is now. His preparation has gone perfectly. He is in outstanding shape. He has a great game plan and a great camp, and he believes that he will emerge the new champion of the world tonight after this fight.
The reigning, defending, undisputed UFC welterweight champion in a division full of killers, he has remained the hunted at 170 pounds. Now, unquestionably staring at his toughest challenger to date, can he go back home as the champion? If he can, another chapter to one of the greatest welterweight legacies the Octagon has ever seen.
The champion is in focus. He is in his prime. He's making his way towards the cage. His training for this camp has been absolutely spectacular. He believes he has a solid game plan, and his mentality coming into this fight is clear and focused.
For this, our main event of the evening. So more than 15 years, the gap in age between these two fighters, and they both possess a similar height and reach. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey. It's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC welterweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 23 wins, no losses. He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Fort Worth, Texas, presenting the challenger, Kelly. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red
This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 34 wins, 12 losses, and one no contest. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds, fighting out of Coconut Creek, Florida, USA, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Ruthless Robbie Lawler.
All right, this is for the championship. You've been giving your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves, just make it official.
This has been one of the most highly anticipated matchups for a long time. And ladies and gentlemen, strap yourselves in, because it's about to go down right now.
Well, New York has been all the rage, but this was a place we visited quite frequently over the last several years. Good to be back at the Pru, the Prudential Center here in Newark, New Jersey, as we get underway. Well, you can feel the tension in the building here. Going to be very interesting to see if he can bottle the emotions, focus on the task at hand as he tries to become a simultaneous two-division UFC champion here tonight. This was the super fight he asked for. Ask and you shall receive. Let's see what he can do with the opportunity. Whiffs on the right hand. Joe, what are you looking for out of him here in the early going?
Robbie Lawler is a true knockout artist, and his kicks are especially powerful. Keep an eye out for those.
And he lands a nice kick. And both guys really throwing with authority. Oh, and he tags him with the straight hand there. Beautifully done by Kelly. Lawler gets caught with that punch. Under 3 minutes now to go in what has been a very fast-paced opening round here.
Oh, he nailed it! The champ is rocked! Lacking! Oh, this is knee!
Oh, he's hurt. He's hurt bad.
Oh! The left hook hits home. That knee might have landed there.
He is in deep danger right now. Deep danger. Vicious attack by Lawler. What a jab. Vicious left hand.
He lands a big left hand there. Big left. 90 seconds now remain in the round. Snaps off the jab effectively there. Kick to the body is there.
Changes stances and switches southpaw. Oh!
Just out of range with the straight left hand. Well, he ate a pretty big head kick there, Joe, and he's... Oh!
This could be it right here.
Oh, he's out. He's out.
That's it. He's out. He's out. Wow. Big roundhouse kick KO for the victory.
Well, that was a no-doubter, Joe, and he's made a career of knocking guys out with kicks, but that one right there might have just been the best yet. Caught the opponent flush, full force, outstanding extension with the leg, and really once he connected with the target, you knew the end of the fight was coming, and immediately his opponent goes to the canvas. A major, major result here in this division tonight.
And let's see if we can get a better look at that from another angle.
Well, stand and cheer, ladies and gentlemen. He wins the super fight to become a two-division UFC champion. That is rarefied air in the Ultimate Fighting Championship. The official decision is inside the octagon. Here is Bruce Buffer.
At 4 minutes, 39 seconds of the very first round, declaring the winner by knockout and new.
Absolutely. remarkable what this fighter was able to accomplish here tonight as he adds his name to a short list of fighters to win a UFC championship in more than one division. He has prided himself on taking on all comers, and tonight he gets the job done in epic fashion. Congratulations to the now two-division UFC champion of the world.
I'm Megan O'Leary, and this is your UFC Minute. Remember when we were telling you that you shouldn't miss this past weekend's monumental super fight? I hate to be that person, but we told you so.
The fans were buzzing, the world was watching, and the Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey was at capacity last weekend when the UFC lightweight champion challenged the welterweight title holder in an epic super fight. When it was over, he had silenced the critics and made history as one of only a handful of fighters to become a world champion in two weight classes.
That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.